Might as well start now. Hey everybody, it's JoeBobJohn102. Back for more stuff on YouTube, I guess. So, it's kind of busy working its way. But that builds suspense, because this is a game in series that, in a series which I just got into, pretty much. I think last summer, actually. But I think it's really, really fun. And if you couldn't read the... If you can read the title and know anything about the series, you might be wondering why I'm recording this one and not one of the later, more modern parts of the series. Well, mostly because technological limitations, I only know how to record things that somehow go through a TV. And also, the most recent game in the series... Oh, jeez. God dang it. If I remember correctly, this one is a short one. But anyway, the most recent installment in the series is on the 3DS, and I don't know how to record on the 3DS. So... And, like, it has something to do with capture cards, which I guess you put in the back of the 3DS in the... Or just wherever the drive slot is, and just do it from there, and put the video's game back. But either way, even if I did know how to record, I wouldn't have the money to do so. So I'm recording this one first, even though there are two more recent games in the series, which personally, I definitely like. There's no doubt about. The more recent ones being better games than this, at least from what I've heard. I haven't played this game yet, but from what I've heard, like, there's just a lot more stuff in the more recent games than in this one. But I'm not really doing this because this game is fun, although it probably almost definitely will be in some way, shape, or form. Also, by the way, this is the game that I'm playing, if you didn't read the title. This is a great episode start right here. This is more just kind of to get people interested in the games, in the game series. Like a game... Okay. Cool. Yes, we have game pads. The game language has been changed to English, can be changed in the options. Cool. Neo. Save data is required, create save data, yes. Standard... Data save settings for Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. Includes guild cards, download quests, and special bonus data. Sure. Saving extended data. Cool. If you want to play this game, if you want to play Monster Hunter just because it looks fun, then, yeah, get one of the more recent games, Generations 4 Ultimate, or I would recommend Double Cross whenever it comes out. But if you... It's like, eventually I'm going to be, doing stuff online, because there is online mode, and that's what most people say is the most important part of a Monster Hunter game. Heck, even the creators. If you want to play with me, then you would have to get 3 Ultimate, the Wii U version. Get the Wii U version. 3U the 3DS version can only play locally with people with the Wii U version, or other people who have the 3DS version. And by that point, I would just recommend getting 4 Ultimate. I would recommend waiting for Double Cross whenever that comes out. It should be sometime this year. But I've been playing 4 Ultimate in my own time, and like I'm pretty close to G rank in it, near the end of high rank. I've beaten the final like story quest in the caravan quests, and pretty close to the end of high rank in the guild hall quests. Also, I know that this game is rated T for teen, and that goes against my normal sensibilities for recording games on this channel, that they are usually at highest E10+. Gosh dang it, the gameplay is fun. I don't care. But that being said, this game is rated T for teen, so if you aren't universally kind of okayed for that by, like, parents or something, if you don't live alone, then be sure to get, like, parent permission before playing this game. And, like, all parts of the series are T15, so. Yeah. This is gonna be fun. Because 4 Ultimate is fun. And stuff. Yeah, I don't know. Veterans to the series are probably going to be facepalming that I'm recording this at this point in time. But, I don't care. If you'll excuse me, future me, just cut away the part of character customization and I'll show you guys what it looks like afterwards. Alright, so, here's what the character looks like. It's got kind of hair stuff. And his voice sounds like this. Most of the cosmetics won't really matter later on in the game because of armor and stuff. Oh, okay. And I'm also gonna skip ahead of this. I'm gonna have most of the stuff on screen so that you guys can kind of like see what's going on. Stuff, including map, items, hell, some just go with this. And right here. Cool. Neo, bro. Alright. Again, I can't stress this enough. If you're just looking to get into the series because it looks fun, take one of the more recent games, for Ultimate Generations or Double Cross when it comes out. Because they've just generally got more stuff to them. More meat on their bones. I guess, I don't know, speaking of bones. Some bones right there. Yeah. I don't know. Again, T15. Let me see now. Here. On the ESRB rating on the box, it specifically cites blood, crude humor, and fantasy violence as to why this is rated T15. But there is also alcohol usage and tobacco usage as well, a little bit. So, yeah. I don't know, this game is fun, and most of that kind of stuff you won't really pay attention to in the first place. Just generally. Cutscenes. Cutscenes happening. Also, this is, like, most equatable to an RPG. There aren't really that many games like Monster Hunter to equate them to, but it is closest to an RPG. And, like most RPGs, the game starts out slow with exposition and stuff, I guess. There isn't too much of a story, especially in this one. It's more of a story in 4 Ultimate, and as far as I know, 4 Ultimate is the first in the entire series, and also so far last, to have any level of engagement in a story. This game's story is just kind of there to be there, because it needs to, I guess. I don't know. Hello. I'm gonna just avoid voice acting and kind of like say basics. That's really small text. I hope I can change that in the accents and stuff. So that guy's the chief, because his name is Village Chief. Stuff, a very natural village. He's got a pipe. That's the tobacco right there. Don't smoke. It's bad for lungs. Excuse me. It's talking about Lagiacris. Which is, as according to him, most likely what is causing the earthquake, which is just happening in that. So. Stuff. Basically, this village just needs someone to take on the Lagiacris. And I am apparently the closest, the best person for the job at this time. I can just talk to people and stuff. This guy's a very knowledgeable artisan and can make stuff. Can make weapons. Yeah. What he's saying here is that over to the left you can go to the Tenzin port. And there you can do online quests, either online, you know, with a 3DS locally, or by yourself. If you just want to get straight to the majority of the game, which is, you know, hunting monsters, then just go over there and stuff. But I'm gonna be doing this a little bit differently, because like most playthroughs of Monster Hunter games that I've seen, it's kind of involved skipping straight to that. And like, I don't think that's the best way to get people engaged. Like, it'll get people interested immediately, but it won't be telling them all the stuff. I'm not exactly sure how this game goes entirely. I'm guessing it'll be pretty similar to 4 Ultimate, with the exception of like combat and stuff. Like, it'll be mostly the same, just less mounting, more swimming. I know that much. Okay, I can run with R, that's the same. Low. And I'd, we're going to go across this bridge. Do-do-do-do-do. Army's right there. Okay, I got a whetstone. That is used for sharpening Glademaster weapons, but with what I'm going to be going with, that won't be necessary. Hello. Fishmongress. And she just talks about stuff. I don't know. I don't like paying attention to that kind of stuff, mostly. I can go in here, yeah. Yeah, this is my house, apparently. So, it's got, if I can get at the right distance to him. Chamberlain. There are cat people in this game, by the way, if you didn't know. Steward of the Chamber. As long as I'm guest here, he will help me with stuff. I just did not save the progress. And so, yeah, you can save by sleeping in the bed. Taking the liberty of placing a lamp in the item box. Okay, cool. And he also manages DLC and videos and stuff in the gallery. And the furnishings, I'm not really gonna deal with that much. Let me see. Here is your item box, it's mostly the same as 4 Ultimate. And here you can select the equipment. You have a whole 5, 10, 12 weapons to choose from, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, yeah. And a full set of leather armor, which you're already wearing. And those whetstones that the little kid gave you, you would need those if you were using any of the melee weapons, which there are a lot of. You got great swords, you got your long swords, you got swords and shield, dual great sword, long sword, sword and shield, which I was all wearing, dual blades, hammer. Yes, you need to sharpen hammers. A hunting horn. Yes, you can beat things up with horns, and you also need to sharpen those. Lances, gun lances, or as I like to call them, shotguns on sticks. Switch axes, those are your ranged weapons. But you also got your ranged weapons, which are bows, heavy bow guns, or light bow guns. I'm personally going to be going with the bow. But for gathering later on, I am going to be using a melee weapon for reasons which you will see if you haven't played this game before. And if you have played the series before, then you will probably understand what I mean with the items and stuff. I have nothing in my inventory. Let me see, what is it? Prism Shroom Lamp. Rushing shaped like a mushroom. Let it go. Okay, cool. I'm not really going to be dealing with that kind of stuff. I don't know what's on that could get me go. I don't know. Anyway. So. Do you fancy a look for the sun? What happened to Mug of Woods? Okay. So, like, I'm not deal with. Wait. Let's see. Outfitter. Oh, okay, I can buy weapons here. So far you just got, like, bone versions of all the existing weapons. And you can also look at what they look like by pressing X. You can see little descriptions and stuff. Yeah, and you can also buy armor. I'm not gonna do that. I think I'm fine with the leather for a little bit. Probably gonna be. If I remember correctly, I was supposed to go out here. Again, the start of this game is gonna be a bit slow. Usually are. And also slower than 4 Ultimate because they were still kind of clunky with getting a story going. Cam, ancestors have a saying wherever you go, there you are. Okay, so the map over in the right, it's kind of small because we've got moving stuff, left stick move around, hold on R button run, close that. Alright. And also in addition to that, it's not really matter right now, you can switch to. Okay, never mind. Mountains and big water basin and stuff. And it's cool. And, like, if there's another thing that Monster Hunter has going for it besides, you know, combat, it's also stunning visuals. Like, just. Not necessarily in terms of graphic quality, but, like, stuff just looks magnificent and stuff. He's telling us about what the... Yeah, you run by holding down R, but if you look at the top of the screen, the yellow bar, it's slowly depleting while I'm running. That means that I'm running out of stamina. And if I run too low, then... stuff. He's talking about gamepad stuff. I'm gonna just kind of. There's some stuff down here. The combo list, a virtual D-pad, quick access to your item pouch, but, like, for the most part, I'm just going with not bothering with most of that. In 4 Ultimate, I would use the. Virtual touchscreen a lot to Since it doesn't have a right analog stick, but I'm just going to be using the analog stick here. So, as you say in here, not sure if this has the... There it is. Okay. Not sure if my controls... Because, like, there was something weird in 4 Ultimate with the bow controls where there were two versions to it. Two sets of controls. Okay, I've got the good kind. Basically, you just... Okay, like in 4 Ultimate, there was a control scheme where you use R to fire, and that was just kind of weird to me. And now I've killed him. Killed this Amphinoth over here. These are basically cows in the Monster Hunter universe. But, like, also dinosaurs. And once you've killed stuff, you can, drop off pieces of them. Should also be noted, what I did there was crouch. I did that because, like, you actually gather stuff faster while crouching. A little bit of tidbit right there. So it's not too useful for Aftermath since you can usually get both cards before it despawns. But with some of the later stuff, at least in 4 Ultimate, you're gonna want to be doing the crouch collect in order to get stuff. I'm gonna be doing most of the teaching myself, so anyway, I've got beehive here and you can get honey from it, of course. And now I can't anymore. It doesn't despawn like it does in 4 Ultimate to say, hey, look, you've already gathered from this one. And you also got mushrooms over here. If I can get a blue mushroom, that is pretty common. They're what I need for what I'm about to show you. Like, just kind of how to get healing items. Like, the best part about the Monster Hunter games is that you, like, find most of the materials you need to make stuff yourself. You don't need to buy everything from the store. I can find an herb plant. Where's an herb plant? Can't find any herb plants. Oh well, I'll just go over to the next area. There's something in here. Frick, I'm lost. Anyway. With the bow, there's something with the bow called, critical distance. Like, I'm not gonna get too far into combat, but, like, basically, if you're a certain distance away from whatever you're shooting at, then you will deal more damage, and you are notified of this by the screen shaking, when you're at the proper distance. Need a plant to get stuff from. It's supposed to be going this way, okay. Yeah, okay. It's just the map is very small relative to what I'm used to. Also, that's what happens when you run out of stamina, by the way. You start kind of, like, slowly running, and if you go all the way, that's what happens when your stamina bar turns reddish. If it goes down all the way, then you'll have to stand for a little bit when you stop running. Wait, is critical distance just something in 4 Ultimate? It might be. Oh, I got holes there. That's neat. No. Get more meat. The map's smaller than I expected. Wish that there's some way to, like, increase the heads up display size. Like, hold on. Oh, looking that on. No. Is there a way to... Alright, nope, never mind. I guess not, I'm gonna have to deal with that small map. Okay, I've zoomed in now. Yes. Wait. This is the way I'm supposed to go. I think this is the way I'm supposed to go. Give it here. Give it here. Yeah. Here we are. Oh dear. That's a problem. Things got destroyed. This dude's here. What'd you do back in the village? Wasn't I supposed to be looking for the elder son? Here we are. Earthquake damage. Talk to the dude. Here we are. Man sent for me to look at stuff. Okay, he's a different guy, he just looks the same. Chief's son, standing among the rubble. Used to be base camp, but isn't anymore because it's broken. Where stuff was left, the Quake really messed it up, need to fix it. Went back to the village. Okay, Okay. Giving him the meat that I got from the Apennaw. Is that it? Okay. No, just return to the village. Okay. Okay. I'll learn the map. I'll learn the area soon enough without having to look at the map, but it's still kind of confusing with how small the map is. Tokidoo. Liberty State Junior, blah blah. Everyone, see the icon at the bottom, that's the village gate, okay. Cool. Going there. Here. Also, the yellow bar has shortened, that's because my avatar is getting hungry. I'll get to how to get food to eat later. Yes, but yeah, okay. Going back to Moga Village now, because completed the quest and stuff. Yeah. Wasn't really a quest. Also, you can see a map of the. Of Moga Village on the touchscreen. Hello, good sir. No problem for the meat, bruh. Digging new stuff. Things. Here we are. One of the breeze voices. Fix the roads, and. Okay, yeah. So, as I said before, the first few quests in the single player are a little bit slow. Oh. Okay. Now what resources do I need to deliver? Oh wait, no, there are resource points. Okay, that's weird. I don't know. Anyway. The chief is happy that I saved his son, but now the village is base camp is in shambles and stuff, and he's not happy about that. Over there. And I get more money! Right. This is who you talked to get the port, by the way. I'm standing inside of him. Okay. It's weird. Over there. Don't need free to places. And yeah, I don't need to do that yet. Not yet. Basically, what I'm going to try and do anyway is I'm going to play the single player until I get up to fighting a monster that would be an urgent quest in the multiplayer, and then I'm going to go over to the port town and do the Kian Urchin quests as far as I can stuff. I don't know. The Baron Artisan, you're talking about forging. If you're making a metal weapon, you'll need ore. Making some bone stuff, you'll need bones. Bring materials, money, he'll make stuff. That's what he does. It's a smithy. Currently, I can't. Well, I can't really make any of these yet because I don't have the stuff to mix them. And I already have this one. So, yeah. Can't really do that yet. We'll be getting to that stuff later. There's another person that needs it. Okay. I can go to the farm now. The farm. Talk to this dude. Hello, head farmer. I am the person that everyone's fussing about. Plays this in our hands. Okay, I got a blue mushroom. Cool. I need herbs. That's what I need. Oh, there's a place. The shrine stuff. Cool. Probably like the sword shrine for ultimate. I don't know. Anyway, just gonna go this way. Alright, what can I do now? Yeah, I talked to you about stuff. Alright. Guild sweetheart over here. She is okay. What am I supposed to do now? Okay. Right. I'm gonna. Huh. What do I do? Perhaps I shouldn't have been skipping over what people have been saying. Alright, anyway, whatever I have to do, I'm gonna be saving that for the next episode. It's just the start of something that's gonna be. It's gonna be great, I hope. Not that people think highly of the Monster Hunter series, the people who have played it anyway. So, that'll be it for now. Next episode, we'll hopefully be able to find out what the frick I need to do. See you guys then. Bye-bye.